Dışişleri Başkanı olan daha önce bir video gösterimlerinden katılacaklardı. Fakat şu anda telefonla katılmak istiyorlar. Buyursunlar efendim.
Overall, the Umma was going down. And that went down, down, until the fall of Baghdad in 2003. And since then, I think we are bouncing back. The Ummah is trying to come back. We are, when we look at our history, when we look at our ancestors, we are so proud of. When we look at the statistics, when we look at our present status, it is a very big problem. We need to do something about it. As they say, don't curse the darkness. It is better you lit a candle. And that's why what we are trying to do today. When I visited Moscow, I met Brother Abdullah and he asked me if I can join them. I didn't think twice. I think this is what we need. The internet was invented long ago, but our contribution to it is very negative. We don't have that much contribution, we are only users. When we talk about Muslims on the internet, about the virtual world, there are numbers. How many users? How many people on Facebook? How many people on Twitter? But you can't look at the first 100 big companies on the internet, on IT, none of them is a Muslim or owned by a Muslim. Not because we don't have intellect like others, but we don't know the way. And I hope now we know the way. Because we have been told, and I was listening to Abdullah earlier when he said, people, they think we are made by Putin or made by Russia or Obama or this or that. You know why? Because in our subconscious, we think that we Muslims, we are able to do things. If we do something, there is something, someone else behind it, and not a Muslim there. Why is that? Because the bombardment on a daily basis, two things the international media are conveying to us, are conveying to the whole world. One thing, we Muslims, we have nothing to be proud of in our history. And the second thing, we Muslims, we are guilty in our presence. We are guilty in our presence. We are responsible for terrorism, we are responsible for deportations, we are responsible for integrism, whatever they call it, and that's what the media conveys to us. Now, it is inshallah time, because this Ummah, if you look back at its history, even those cameras, you look at them, you look at the civilization, you look at the, whatever you look at, most of them are Muslim inventions. Every single day, when you wake up, you are surrounded by Muslim inventions. However, our present is not that good. We have to look at our past in a positive manner, and inshallah we have to build on it, and we have to move forward. Now, 95% of the media is owned by one group of people. The whole media, international media, is owned by a group of people, we know them. If you go to the big corporation, what we have? We have oil and gas. That's not an output. And I remember a saying by the president of Israel. He said the output of the Israeli brains is more than the output of the Arab oil. I think it is time that we not only have oil, but we have brains as human beings, as Muslims. The Muslim Ummah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chosen it. Not because of ethnicity, not because of blood, not because of ancestors. They chosen it because it's the Ummah that is carrying the Risala. It is the Ummah that has inherited the prophecy of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the prophets before him. Inshallah, this is a good start, and we are going to put the Ummah on the map. And inshallah, in the future, the generation to come after us, they will look back and say, in one day, one of the days, people met in Istanbul, and they made sure that Salam World is on the map, and Salam World, inshallah, is the Qibla of Muslims in the virtual world. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.